Hi, in this video we will try to learn how to cleanse our data for report uses. So you can see here I have a sample file, and you can see I have some data in the cell for salary. We have name and salary, and if you see here you have an Excel sheet which has merged rows and columns. So let's see how we can import this data into Power BI and how we can clean the data. So I'll use this as a source. So let's click on get data. So it will allow us to locate the file. When we select Excel worksheet, we'll choose salary data. Now it will prompt us to select the sheet from where we'll import our data. So we have only one sheet. As you can see here, it is showing multiple columns and then null values. So these all have to be handled, and then we can create the report. So initially what we can do, we can load the data and then we can go to transform and do, or if you want, we can directly go click on transform data, which will take us to Power Query Editor window. So let's try with load. We'll load the data and then we'll start transforming it. So our data is loaded, but if you'll see what kind of data it is loading, then let it load first. So now you can see here we have table, but the column names are not correct, and the value for this is again, it's showing little different. So the way we want the data is not here. So let's go and try to correct the data. So what we'll do, we'll click here, click on transform data, and initially in this video we'll just try to see what all transformation we can do to our data. So first we need to remove this row. So we have option to remove top rows. So let's search, or we have option remove top rows. Let's remove row 1 for now, and as soon as you do that, you see one step gets added here, that is to remove the top rows. Now you can see this column you want to move as a header. So to do that, use this. Now you can see you have header name came as name and salary. Next, this column does not make sense to us. So what we can do, we can remove this column also. And what, as soon as we are doing all these things, we see all the steps are getting added. Now we already have change type here and here. Let's remove this, because once we will do every changes, then we'll change the type of the columns. So we'll remove these two. Now we'll remove this column also. So sometimes it may happen that your worksheet contains more than these two columns and you just need these two columns only. So what you can do, you can select these two and you can click on remove other columns. So it will make sure that if any sheet has these two columns, it will just pick those two columns only. For now we'll just remove this column, and you see one more step gets added. Now in this column, if you'll see, you have total, which we don't need for our report. So how we can remove total? We have option to filter the data. So we can see here, we'll uncheck this total and then we'll click OK. So we got another step. Now here we are seeing that with the same name we have two records, but there is slight change that we have spaces there. So how to fix that? Before even fixing, if we are keeping this, what issue we will see? So let's try to apply the change and then see what happens. So, and later on we'll move and change it. So till here, if we try to create a report, and if we are trying to create a chart, axis name and then value is salary. Now you can see here that salary, although we have numbers there, but it's not allowing us to do aggregations like sum or average. So that means there is problem with the data type. So we'll have to change the data type of that column. Second thing, you'll see that for soup, we have two multiple entries there. So those things we'll try to clean and we'll see how the data gets updated. So first thing, we'll just remove the spaces. So we'll go to transform and there is a option called trim. And as soon as we do that, we get another step and it removes that. Now you see this value shows us text. So we have to change the type to decimal. And then you see again another change type step got added. Now we'll apply this change and we'll see what change happens to our report. So let's go back to our report and you see that this is now single entry. So now let's quickly select the report and we'll see what all aggregations are available now. Now since that number changed from string to number, we can see we have sum, average, everything available. And you can order this data based on your need. If you want to order by name, you can do order by name. You want to order by salary, you want to do ascending or descending order, everything you can do. Now in case if you want to order data on some other column which you don't want to show here, what you can do, you can put them in a tooltip section and that field will be available in your ordering. So that also you can try to do. Now we'll do one more transformation. We are seeing that these names are not in proper manner. So you'll see Sue has first letter is capital, but this name does not have. So we'll either try to make it, you know, first letter capital, or we can convert into all caps or all small. So let's go back and do those changes. So to do that, we can again go here and we can go to transform. There is an option of lowercase, uppercase, and then in case if you want first letter to be capitalized, you can do that and then see the first letter got capitalized. Now what I want my data to be in this order only. But right now if you see, the data order is, data seems to be in this order because we are arranging it on salary. But as soon as we'll do it on name, it goes like this. But what we want how our data has been entered, it should be on the same way. So what we'll do, we'll try to add an index column and it will make all of them in that index list. So here we can go and we can go to add columns and we see here we have option to add index and we want to start it from one and let's name it sort order. So what we want our report to be displayed on this order only. Now this will be available there in our report. So let's go quickly apply that change. And then what we'll do, because we cannot put that here in our visual, so we'll put it in tooltips. and we'll see that our field is available for ordering. So we'll do sort order and we'll do A to Z. And you can see now our data appears the same way which we have entered. So you can see first three names here, same way the data is being shown here. So this way you can add an index column. Now there are other options also in adding columns. If you want custom column, or you want to have a M function to be added. So in Power Query Editor, the language which works here is M. So in case if you want to see what all code inside these steps, what you can do, you can just right click here and you can go to Advanced Editor, and that will give you all the steps that has been taken to process your data or to cleanse your data. So all these steps are available here. So if you are comfortable with M language, you can do that. And let's try another way of transformation, where we'll try some transforms like transpose, like unpivot columns, and we'll see how we can get the data converted. So we'll add another source here. So let's go add another Excel workbook, and this is our sales data Excel. So you can see here our data is in this way, where you know month wise data for given countries. And let's go and modify this data to meet our requirement. So first thing what we'll do, we'll make this row as header. So let's move on. So we'll use first row. We'll have to remove these steps because we have already the application has already done by itself. So what we'll do, we'll remove this first row. So to do that, we'll again go and remove top one row. Now we'll promote this row as header. So now you can see all the months are there, but we still have this name as column one. So let's rename this to country. Now we don't want total column, so let's remove total column. So we'll uncheck this and that step gets added. Now next, what we want data for month and country, month, and then the data, that is sales amount or whatever we can say here. So what we'll do, we'll unpivot this data. So we'll go to transform. I think I have some issue. Let's save it and then we'll reopen it. So now let's go there and try to modify it again. So in case if you want to rename this name, we can put it as sales data and that data gets updated. Now I'll go to transform and we'll select these columns and we'll do unpivot. So here you can see this unpivots the data. We'll rename the column again. We'll rename it as month. and this one is sales amount. Now we see the type is already assigned here, so we need not do anything. But what we want country to be in capital case. So let's go transform and change it to uppercase. So our data is perfect now. Let's apply and work on this. So we have applied, we'll go to next page, and in that page we'll create a report on sales data. So we want a bar chart to be there on sales data. Let's select this one. So we want access to be on country and then lesion to be on months and sales amount as values. So we can see here for all the months in given countries whatever is the sales amount. Now if we want to order that, we can order by sales amount, sort ascending descending in each case, and let's make it so this way we can transform the data in Power BI. We have many more transforms which are you can merge data from two tables, like in case if you have primary key table and foreign key table, let's say department and employee, and if you want to merge both of them in a single result set, you can go ahead and do that using merge queries. In case if you are getting data from multiple sources and you want to combine them with the union, you can go ahead with append queries. Then if you want to replace certain values with any value, you can go ahead and do that. So you can select that column and then you can use replace values. In case if you want to remove certain rows or if you want to keep certain rows, you can go ahead with this. If you want to split your column on certain delimiters, if your column has say multiple values with certain delimiters, you can go ahead and do that. Or if you want to split the column by positions, you can do that. Then what columns you want to choose, that you can do. This will allow you to duplicate things or delete certain tables or data sources. Then you can transpose, reverse rows. You have you can change the data types. You can move the data to left, right, or whatever, shifting of data, then extract values. So all those things you can do on Power BI, and these things you can achieve through the M language also. You can use that in any additional column if you want, you can go ahead and apply that. So whatever the steps which you are seeing here in the advanced editor, basically these are M functions or M steps which you are seeing here. So what you can see that in first step we are using source. In the source we are assigning this value, and then second step from source again you are accessing the data portion of it, and then this value is used in next step. So that is how you keep assigning step by step, and that's how your Power BI refresh gets processed.